taking cooperation to the digital age. Given rapid game-changing developments in technology, Africa and Europe must work together to advance and harvest the economic benefits of the digital economy, and at the same time, prevent a counterproductive widening of the digital gap. Investments in digital technologies can make an important contribution to growth and development by fostering productivity gains from continuous innovation. Given our fast-growing populations in Africa, we are of course keen to work together with the job creation potentials of new technologies rather than concentrating solely on jobs destined to disappear in the digital age. Faster growth, sustainable development, and job creation are also vital for reducing irregular migration from Africa to Europe. In our globalized world, people can see disparities in standards of living across regions quite easily. This means that there must be increased openings for entrepreneurship and jobs in home countries for those who would otherwise embark on risky, dangerous journeys in search of opportunity. In Nigeria, we're taking urgent and practical steps to provide such opportunities for our rapidly increasing youth population. Our advisory group on technology and creativity has been working to build an ecosystem for funding, training, infrastructure, and intellectual property protection. Under our social investment program, 75,000 young people are being trained in coding, software development, hardware maintenance, animation, and data management. And we're set to train another 200,000 young men and women. Similarly, we have established 8 technology hubs to support tech startups across our 6 geopolitical zones and the 2 major cities of Abuja and Lagos. We've encouraged partnerships to establish venture funds to support innovation and are now engaged in talks to establish a $500 million innovation fund with bilateral and multilateral partners. We'll be deploying digital methods and tools on a larger scale to expand learning opportunities for young Nigerians as conventional education through bricks and mortar institutions, can no longer be viable given the huge numbers and limited resources. Already 200,000 out of our 500,000 young graduates in our NPower scheme have tablet devices which we use for on-the-job training and further skills acquisition. This experience will guide our efforts as we seek to expand digital literacy at earlier stages of education. Similarly, our education curriculum is being reworked to emphasize science, technology, engineering, arts, and mathematics. The arts have been included because of the growing recognition, of course, of the strengths of our country, especially in the arts, music, film, and literature. With regard to e-commerce, Nigeria has firms like Jumia and Konga, while Paystack and Paga are leading in enabling digital payments. In addition, young enterprising Nigerians, including those who make all sorts of commodities, have been using platforms like Instagram, YouTube, and even Twitter as their marketplace. Financial technology is being used in our efforts to rapidly scale up financial inclusion. Working with our banks, telcos, and fintech companies, we've used digital tools and platforms to provide interest-free microloans to up to 1.3 million Nigerians, and another 300,000 receive conditional cash transfers by the same means. We hire, pay, and train online over 500,000 young men and women in the largest post-tertiary direct jobs program in Africa. Through participation in these schemes, present and future beneficiaries will be brought into databases for unique biometric identification. I'm optimistic that our efforts will attract the strong support and active engagement of our partners in the European Union. Indeed, already we have some good examples of that. In the African Digital Leaders Traineeship Program, which is a partnership between Ventures Platform of Nigeria and Enterprise Lithuania, with funding from the European Union. This innovative program will provide digital skills training for 50 young Nigerians in Lithuania, while at the same time relieving temporary labor shortages in that country. A reintegration component is also built into the package. Also, the International Center for Migration Policy Development is launching a pilot college of practical skills and startup center in Nigeria to train 1,000 Nigerian youth, including 300 women, per year in directly marketable skills. This is a collaboration with a Nigerian private university, the Godfrey Okoye University, the Austrian Federal Economic Chamber, Wi-Fi International, Modul University Vienna, University of Natural Resources and Life Sciences Vienna, and the Center for Development Research in particular. We invite other EU member states to similarly partner with us to impart skills, raise resources, promote investment, and provide the infrastructure to build a digital economy in Nigeria and indeed the rest of Africa. Excellencies, the conversations we have started here must continue formally and informally. We have a moment in the history of Europe-Africa relations that can yield tremendous mutual benefit. Let us seize this moment. Thank you very much.